Now, how to calculate due dates? Let me explain it. Now, number one, we are having June 30th, 2016. Now, June 30th, 2016 plus 30 days plus 3 days of grace. Now, this becomes, now let me clarify one thing, already we have discussed it, once again I am discussing that if days are given, we have to calculate days, and if months are given, we have to calculate month, then forget about the days. If the month is for 28, for 29, for 30, for 31, whatever days are, we are going to calculate one month only. Is it clear? So now, June 30, we are having 30 days. So it will be July 30, 2016 plus 3 days of grace. This is equal to August 2, 2016. Second part. Now January 29, 2015 plus 1 month plus 3 days of grace. Now here be careful. January 29, 2015 plus 1 month. Now after January we are having February. So this will be equal to February 28, because 1 month means February, and 2015 was not a leap year. Is it clear? So it is February 28 plus 3 days of grace. This is equal to March 2015. Now third part, November 27, 2015 plus 3 months plus 3 days of grace. Now 2015 is not a leap year, but 2016 is a leap year. So whenever we are discussing all these things, be aware about the leap year. Now November 27, we are having 3 months, then December 27, January 27 and February 27. So we are having February 27, 2016 plus 3 days of grace. Now February 27, their month is over. Now the February 2016 is for 29 days. So we are having 3 days extra. So it will be February 28, February 29 and 1st March. Okay. So this will be March 1, 2016. So main thing is to be careful about the days, months and leap year.